In modding, we usually use the original file as a base or as reference, be it a model or a sound file. Our workflow would usually be to extract the original file, customize it, export, and install my modified file with the same file name as the original. So today, we'll be going over file extraction and file replacement. When we go to our main MHRUnpack folder, the one located in our Steam library, you wouldn't be able to find individual game files. This is because these are all compressed in these chunk.pack files. In order to extract these, we have two tools at our disposal, Extract-Rise-Pak and MHRUnpack. Now the wiki has a guide written up about using Extract-Rise-Pak. I'll only be going over it briefly. Instead, I want to focus on MHRUnpack because this is my preferred method for extracting game files. There are three components in using Extract-Rise-Pak: the batch file itself, RE tool, and MHRPC.list. RE tool is the program that unpacks the .pack containers, while MHRPC.list contains a list of directories that will tell RE tool what to unpack. We need the batch file because this is what executes the RE tool program. So to use the batch file, all you would need to do is simply drag the rechunk000.pack file over the Extract-Rise-Pak. Thankfully, you would only need to download the batch file since it would also download the latest versions of RE tool and the list for us. Now the whole process will take a few minutes. That's because it is extracting each file in the list. If you wanted individual files, we would need to remove the items in the list file that we don't need. Now we could do that, or we can use MHRUnpack. Just like the extract pack batch, we would need the list file. So after downloading and extracting MHRUnpack, place the list file in the same directory. Unlike the extract pack batch, however, this tool has a GUI. When you open the program, can drag our chunk file into it. Here we can see all the files will be listed like it would be in a file explorer. So we have our parent directories and our child directories. Get the file you want, you would simply select the checkbox of our file. Select extract. You will select our MHRUnpack demo folder, select OK. As you can see, we have our extracted file. While we haven't made any custom files yet, we can do a simple file swap for our demonstration on file replacement. Let's say we want to do a simple file swap of the leather armor, PL001, with the Kimura chest, PL200. Okay, so we would need to create the file path of the leather armor in our mod installer of choice. Here we have our file swap demo mod, and that we have natives, STM, layer, mod, F, and PL001. Afterwards, we can copy the Kimura body chest and rename this file. So fbody001. Let's install the mod and see what happens. So here, the model has been replaced, except for the textures. Remember that because you only swapped the model file, the rest of the texture files still default to that of the leather armor. So in order to make the model look like the Kimura armor, we need to replace the rest of the files as well. So let's copy fbody files, and again rename them to fbody001. Alright, so the Kimura armor has successfully been swapped. So next episode will be on the import and export of models into Blender.